Hi everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to completely erase your MacBook and reinstall the brand new macOS Sequoia from scratch. Maybe you want to give your Mac a fresh start, fix some annoying issue, or prepare it for resale. Whatever the reason, this step-by-step guide will help you to do it the right way. So let's get started. Okay, the first things you need to do is backup any important files, photos, or documents on your Mac. Once you erase the Mac, everything will be permanently deleted. There is no going back. Okay, so you can use Time Machine with an external hard drive or just copy your files to a iCloud or a USB drive. Now, shut down your MacBook. Just click on the Apple logo at the top left corner of the screen and choose Shutdown. And wait for a few seconds until the screen goes black and the macOS completely powers off. Once your Mac is off, we need to enter macOS recovery mode. This is where we will erase the internal drive and install the new system. Okay, so if you have an Apple Silicon Mac, like one with an M1, M2 or M3 chip, press and hold the power button. Keep holding it until you see the message loading startup options. You can see on the screen. When the options appear, click on options. Then click continue. After a few seconds, you will see the macOS utilities windows. From here, click on Dix utility and then click continue. Once you are inside Dix utility, now on the sidebar, click on the top level drive. So it's usually labeled something like Macintosh SD. This is my whole internal drive and you can see the SSD size of around 500 GB. Then click the erase button at the top of the Dix utility window. In the erase dialog box, give the drive a name. You can leave it as a Macintosh SD or name it anything you like. Okay. So for the format, you need to select APFS. Then click erase. After that, you will see another button that says erase Mac. Click on it. Now a confirmation message will pop up saying, are you sure you want to erase this Mac? Just click on erase Mac and reinstall. That's it. Your Mac will now start the erasing process and prepare for the fresh installation of macOS Sequoia. The process may take a few minutes to complete. After that, you need to activate your Mac. Here, you will need to connect to a Wi-Fi network. So just look at the top right corner of the screen and you will see the Wi-Fi icon. Click on it and you need to choose your Wi-Fi network from here and accordingly you can enter the password. After a few seconds, you should see a message saying that your Mac is activated. Once that's done, click on exit and it will return to the main recovery screen. Now we are back at the main utility window. This time you need to click on Reinstall macOS Sequoia and then click continue. Click continue again. After a moment, the macOS Sequoia installer will load. Then agree to the terms and conditions. Again, click on agree and you will now be asked to choose the Dix where you want to install macOS. So select the drive you just erased. It should be named Macintosh SD or whatever you named it earlier. Okay. Then click continue. You might see a message that says your computer is not connected to a power source. Don't worry. This just means your MacBook is running on battery and Apple wants to make sure your Mac does not shut down during the installation. Installing macOS takes time, so and if your Mac turns off midway, it could cause problem. So just connect your charger to a power source and the warning will go away. At this point, your Mac will begin downloading the macOS Sequoia installing files from Apple server. This can take a while depending on your internet speed. So in my case, it took almost 40 minutes. So just be patient, or you can grab a cup of coffee or take a short break while it finishes. Once the download is complete, your Mac will automatically restart and begin installing the new system. It might restart several times during the process and you will see a progress bar on the screen. Just be patient and let it finish. Don't shut it down, okay? When the installation is done, your Mac will boot into the setup screen, just like a brand new device. Now you need to just follow the on-screen instruction and start by choosing your country or region. Then you need to select setup as new and click continue. Pick your preferred language, then connect to Wi-Fi. and move on to a creating your user account. Here you will be asked to enter your full name, an account name and a password. Then confirm the password to continue. Then agree to the terms and conditions to proceed. Some steps can be skipped for now and done later if you prefer. Once you are done with the setup, you will be land at the macOS Sequoia desktop, clean and fresh and ready to use. See, you can see it. And that's it guys, you have successfully erased your MacBook and reinstalled the macOS Sequoia from scratch. If this video helped you out, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe for more simple tech tutorials, and feel free to drop a comment if you get stuck or have any question. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.